February 5th, 1888, a red letter date in opera history. The great Giuseppe Verdi hadn't composed an opera in 15 years, but tonight the opera world was set to see his new work, Othello, premiering in Milan's beautiful La Scala. Othello is perhaps Verdi's greatest opera, considered among the all-time best. For this performance, the audience came from all over Europe. And locally, Verdi was presented with a silver cup containing cards and autographs from every citizen of Milan. Now, after any successful premiere, a composer might expect to make a few bows, but Verdi was called for an unprecedented 20 ovations. Enthusiastically, listeners tossed their hats and handkerchiefs high in the air. Many wept as they cheered the composer and his composition. At long last, the crowd started to disperse, and the composer left the opera house. But even then, Verdi was acclaimed. Fans had unhorsed Verdi's carriage and willingly wheeled him under their own manpower. Finally, in his room alone, he still could not escape the applause. At 5 o'clock in the morning, the people were still bellowing in the streets, "Viva Verdi! Viva Verdi!" How did Verdi react to all this attention? Through the opera house ovations, his calm face never moved a muscle. Reports claim that he appeared to be the only restrained person in the theater. Rather than bursting with pride, Verdi was unruffled, though somewhat embarrassed by the continuing bedlam. This is not to say that Verdi was aloof or acted as he felt superior to the crowd or was condescending towards them. Haughtiness just was not a part of this composer's makeup. Honors never turned his head. When the king offered to make him Majus di Buste, Verdi answered modestly, "Musician I was born, musician I remain." He was known to have many friends from all walks of life. He talked with kings in palaces and with organ grinders on the streets. Verdi had long since learned that life involves both triumph and rejection. Neither mattered very much nor lasted very long, Verdi had found out, and he found that the importance of being objective was simply to be conscious of who he was and to welcome all walks of life, to live one's life to the best of one's abilities, with or without victory. With this quiet resolution, he moved on to write the famous comic opera and his apex in comic writing throughout his career, the opera Falstaff. Often we think of failures and rejections as the most difficult test of our character. But sometime in the vanity of success, that can be the hardest assault on our humble faith. God desires of us who knows what applause can do, us who knows that acolytes can raise us and lift us to levels that might make us feel bigger or better than others. God desires of us to know that the applause we might receive this week or this year are for Him. Are you ready for it? Think of this. The wisdom of Solomon's Proverbs often strike to the very heart of real life. Consider the extent of Solomon's success in the world and fame, and hear these words. The crucible for silver and the furnace for gold, but man is tested by the praise he receives. Proverbs 27:21. Let us pray. Lord, I admit that I find myself loving the sound of praise for my work. Help me to receive that applause with grace and humility. Help me to accept any praise and then quickly look ahead to the challenges of tomorrow, not boasting of my yesterdays. Amen. Friends, remember, like Verdi, we often receive accolades and applause. But remember, we also have downtimes. And keeping in our humble spirits, we too can be humbled, like Christ was humbled on the cross. We too can be humble in giving of ourselves to others. Accolades only last for a moment, but how we respond to them show our true selves and who we are deep inside. Go in peace. Serve the Lord. Stay safe. Thanks be to God.
creatura, io di canti